Rated M for mature.
The following program originally aired live to a chatroom audience and may not be suitable for all ages. The duration has been reduced for this on-demand archive. It contains mature content, explicit gaming coverage, and a girl.
Why not?
Yeah.
Hey guys, welcome to the all new game show here on thestream.tv. I am Jim. I will be checking out your chats over at the Justin.tv chat room. We are talking rage. Rage! Have a little bit of rage towards rage, but we'll get into that. But first, Nicole Z.
Oh, hey, that's me. Nicole Z here. I will not be monitoring your Twitters because I forgot my laptop at home. But I sent everything to, no.
Oh, there's a monitor there.
How dare you? I sent a bunch of things
to
Jim, so he'll be
Is that more accurate?
That is way less accurate.
All right.
I live with my parents.
That doesn't matter.
I also have a Z-list, and you can participate by going to thestream.tv/theZ-list. And if you guess number one, you will win a token to enter in a grand prize drawing where you could win and Xbox 360.
Yay! But first, we're gonna do a little bit of combo. Quick hits of news you may have missed this past week, starting with Rage Rage! The PC version of Rage has some issues. There's a little bit of crashing, some texture pop. It's happened to me, and it's really, it pisses me off. Id Games usually builds, they usually build their games on the computer and then they port to console. This time they've done it differently. They have a new program, Tech 5, that allowed them to develop the game over all platforms at once. Mostly, they're saying that the problems are mostly caused by drivers on AMD and NVIDIA's graphics cards.
So they're blaming other people.
Yeah, which, you know, I can understand. Maybe there's a little bit of frustration there. Id founder John Carmack was saying he doesn't see the PC as a leading platform for gamers. Now, as much as that hurts me in my heart region, he's right. He's right. I mean, I am a PC gamer, but there aren't that many of us as far as comparison to console gamers. But the Id fan base, which are core PC gamers, are not happy about that at all. More tunable settings are apparently coming. I can't wait because I really haven't played much of the game at all, and it's a lot of fun. But again, we'll get into that later.
Oh, hey. So, hey, PC gamers. You know what? After that last story, things aren't really going your way.
No.
So,
give us some hope, Nicole.
Oh, wait. You wanted hope?
Yeah.
Too bad, because Red Dead Redemption will not be coming to the PC. At least anytime soon, or ever. I'm just trying to be optimistic for you.
Sure.
Rockstar has released a statement saying, all we can say is that whenever it's viably, technically, developmentally, and business-wise for us to release a game for the PC or any other particular platform, we will, and we usually do. Unfortunately, that is just not the case 100% of the time for all platforms. To PC gamers, we hope that between the Grand Theft Auto titles, the forthcoming L.A. Noire, and Max Payne 3, you'll have plenty of great Rockstar action to enjoy. In other words, it sucks to be you.
Yeah.
If you like cowboys and PC gaming, but go to somebody else, and they completely abandoned you and they hate you. And I don't know why they're bringing L.A. Noire to the PC, because Red Dead Redemption was so,
yeah.
I know, I don't know what, because Red Dead was so much more fun, and I'm gonna have time, and I feel bad for you, because you get to run ponies.
In space, no one can hear you apologize. CCP's thank you. CEO issued an apology to Eve gamers. There was a recent blog post by Hilmar Peterson who said, quote, I was impatient when I should have been cautious, defiant when I should have been conciliatory, and arrogant when I should have been humble. Basically, he says he was caught up in expanding the game. The Eve community is incredibly tight-knit, and they're so all about this game. They even have a player-elected go-between group called the Council of Stellar Management. I fucking love you nerds. Council of Stellar Management. They blame Eve's development of Dust 514 and the upcoming World of Darkness MMO that CCP is working on. For all of these issues, they've apologized. Whether or not they'll do anything about it, it remains to be seen. So we'll see. Hold on. Wait for that. Maybe.
All seven of you playing Eve Online. Oh, I did it. So this is a little old for, on the news base, but I felt the need to right the wrong that was me in saying that this game would never come out ever, let alone this year. Star Wars The Old Republic officially has a release date. It is coming out on December 20th.
Right in time for Christmas.
Right, which is 4 days, I
and
think.
And Life Day, right? Is life? When is Life Day?
Every day. But 4 days, 4 days after Star Wars Galaxies is shut down, Star Wars The Old Republic will start up. It's going to cost $15 for a month or $13 if you buy 6 months.
You get 30 free
chunks.
Days, though, yeah?
I don't know.
I think so. I think you get 30 free days.
I think it's a really smart move on their part because people are going to be busy, so they're going to have a chance to kind of like test the servers and make sure everyone's playing. And a coincidence? I don't think so. They announced the release date for this 1 day, within 24 hours after Blizzard announced they're pushing Diablo 3 into the 12, which would be their main competition. So no one's surprised there. Merry Christmas.
Cluck to police. Skyrim has a thing called Radiant Story, and it kind of acts as a narrator for you. It can cater quests for your character based on your playthrough history. And it does some crazy things that the developers have found out. It creates it created chickens that would report your crimes. So I guess if you're breaking into houses, if you're stealing things, these chickens would report your crimes, and you would get in trouble for that. Bethesda executive producer Todd Howard, in an interview with PC Gamer, said, quote, "Lately we realized that chickens were reporting crimes. I found that very funny. That was just last week. Why are we getting caught? Oh, the chickens are reporting the crimes." The pigs, however, had no comment. Yeah!
This guy! Because
police are pigs.
What? Who were they reporting the crimes to?
I think just in general, the authority would come get you.
Is there an authority, like in Rage?
Sure, why not? I haven't played Skyrim yet.
Oh, that's true. I get to play it next week. I don't want to brag about it, but I'm going to brag about
brag.
It. So, Xbox literally does everything. Oh, wait, that's somebody else's slogan.
Who's?
I don't know. I forget.
Sure.
So, the Xbox 360 will be streaming TV service through companies, through actually 40 media providers. Comcast, Xfinity, and Verizon Fios will be partnering with Microsoft to offer streaming TV. As soon as this holiday season, there'll be sci-fi, HBO even.
G4?
You know, I don't know about that.
Maybe you should figure that out. Do you have anybody you can ask?
I don't, which is sad. But maybe, that'd be awesome, actually.
Employee of the month.
Hey, g4tv.com/thefeed. But this is actually a great opportunity. I don't know how it's going to work exactly. If it's going to be one app or multiple apps on your Xbox dashboard. The dashboard update is expected to come out, rumor, November 15th. It's going to be amazing. Watch TV on your Xbox. It'd be awesome.
And that's Combo. Could I just lower my graphics card? I mean, why did I buy Rage for the PC? Not to lower my fucking graphics card. I have a Radeon HD 6970, 2 gigs of memory on the fucking video card. I'm not turning down my settings to be able to play a computer game.
Then you're not going to be playing Rage, are you?
I'm not.
No, you're going to take a break. Take a break from the Rage.
Yeah, and it's making me angry. So, a little community check-in. Jake M. Larson said to Nicole Z, "I think the Game Show TV should have a Halloween-themed episode." Sounds like a good idea. The last Halloween episode that we did was when we were Left 4 Dead.
That was great.
It was great.
Ah, no, if chat room challenge, can you think of a Halloween group? Oh, you and I. Mm. Halloween themed costumes that involve no effort.
Yeah.
involve no budget, no effort, and
Some fantastic video game duo.
I borrowed a laptop, so I'm back in Justin TV. So I can see what you're saying, start being nicer.
Wario and Waluigi.
Oh,
I like that.
Really
I am weird.
Enough love.
Yeah.
But if we can steer away from overalls, I would really appreciate it.
Sure.
They don't flatter the shape.
No, because and I'm not in college anymore. I used to wear overalls in college.
I wouldn't have talked to you when I was in college.
Not many girls did.
I was Chloe one year because you know what? That is a lazy ass costume. I wore khakis and I found an old t-shirt and I cut it. Lazy.
Under 822 is saying, "Where's the other annoying guy that used to be in the middle?" Oh, poor Gweeds. It's so empty without him.
He actually didn't used to be in the middle. Like, technically, Nicole was in the middle.
Annoying
guy. So you were the annoying
guy
in the middle.
This guy.
And now you've just been moved over.
I'm the annoying guy in the middle.
Rage. All right, so we got Rage, developed by id Software, the people that brought you Doom.
And Quake.
Published by Bethesda Softworks. It is a first-person shooter with some racing elements. And it is for the Xbox, PS3, and the PC, when it's gonna get its fucking drivers fixed. It's a post-apocalyptic Earth situation. After an asteroid has destroyed most of civilization, you wake up from a cryogenic tank that's been buried underground.
Planet of the Apes style.
So, yeah.
You wake up and everyone's dead, and then you go to like that pretty girl who was super pretty, and then she's all like dead.
Oh yeah, everybody's like all mummified in your mm-hmm. little ark next to you.
Yeah.
And Nicole, I'm gonna let you take it from here because I have not played that much of it.
Yeah, so that's kind of the setup. And so that's what you know because of the cutscene in the very beginning that, you know, this asteroid has hit the Earth and the people of present time, kind of I guess now, knew about that. So they put you into sleep as this beacon of hope that would like help restart civilization. You wake up, obviously things didn't go so well, and you walk out of the ark and you get into a van with John Goodman, and that's kind of how the game starts.
It doesn't get any better than that, to be perfectly honest with you.
I mean, yeah, so, I mean, obviously, with right there, the voice acting in this game is great. A lot of the characters, the NPCs, they're individual, or there aren't a lot of, clones. You're not going to see the same dude over and over again.
Yeah.
And they look great. They have great dialogue. Unfortunately, they don't really tell you what's going on. So from the very get-go, you're kind of, even more so than John Marston was in Red Dead, you're kind of just doing favors for people, and you don't know why. And so that was kind of like, I hate to go start this, you know, review, I guess, of the game with the negatives, but there's just really a lack of story from the very get-go. You don't really know what your overarching goal is. You don't know what the main point of the entire game is. You don't know why you're there, what
but
you're
there
trying
is
to accomplish.
One, yeah?
No, I mean, you know, I mean, I know from preview events, and I, you know, went to a preview event at E3 that there's the authority, which mm-hmm. is, I don't know, guys in better suits than me, and they have better guns, and they're the authority, and with that title, I assume they have authority.
or authoritai. Maybe a little bit of
plural.
Both.
If it's plural, Jim.
Sure.
That's if it's a plural.
I'm guessing
authority.
There are more than one of them.
I don't know. There are. There are plenty. but there's no, and they're trying to, you know, keep the man down, and the man is like people who are in the cities like Subway Town and Wellside and Hagar Territory. Those are kind of like the sporadic towns. And you're not really affected by the authority in any way until like disc two. It's just the story is not.
But you're talking about id, and id is not known for making stories.
I know, but it's 2011, and you need to compete with games that have both, you know, gameplay mechanics and story.
So you don't think this is at least a step in the right direction for them?
Oh no, this is totally a step in the right direction for them. Okay, I'm done bitching. Done. Okay. Oh wait, hold on. Before I'm done bitching, the ending's awful. Okay.
Yeah, now, I was gonna say Maya 2913 is saying, is the ending of Rage incredibly disappointing?
It's incredibly disappointing. There's no closure. There's no answers. There's nothing like that. But there is supposed
Rage
to be
Rage 2.
There's but yeah, I'm sure there's gonna be DLC. So story aside, let's talk about shooting people in the face because that's amazing. So you know what is it known for, and that's shooting. And this is a first-person shooter, and you have a plethora of guns at your disposal. You have different kinds up
a
to
plethora.
Four.
Uh-huh. Nice good job, words. Hefe.
Yeah. Four kinds of ammo for each gun. I mean, even though the missions are kind of a little repetitive in that now we need to fight the Ghost Clan, and now we need to find and kill the Shrouded Clan. And it's kind of repetitive in that sense, but you don't care because it's so fun and validating, and you enjoy shooting the enemies.
And
so
that's
much.
What id does well.
They do that perfectly. Yeah. I mean, you saw the game. Didn't you think it was beautiful?
The game is absolutely incredible. I mean, the landscapes, it's one of those things, I don't know. There's very few games. I did it a lot in Deus Ex recently where you stop and you kind of take in these vistas. Crysis 2 was the same way where it's just like, this is incredible. This is why I play a game on the PC. I agree with you also on the character models. The character models are so good. It's very easy to look at this game and think, oh, Borderlands, oh, Fallout. And it's not. It's not at all.
It's not an RPG, first of all.
What's that?
It's not an RPG. There are some crafting elements, which are cool, But it's not an RPG.
No, it's not. I mean, although I do enjoy the driving moments a lot more than I thought I did, or I thought I would, because I'm terrible at driving games, but for some reason, I don't know if it's because of the upgrades I'm getting to my buggy, but I'm kicking ass at races.
The missions that you do for fun, just to upgrade your car, to get more racing certificates, those are really, the rally racing, for example, those are difficult.
They're difficult, but they're fun difficult. Like, I really, I don't know, I enjoy them.
I just don't
them.
Like them.
Really?
Yeah.
I love the rocket mechanic, too. You basically have two sets of weapons. You have your miniguns on your buggy, or you can have rockets, the homing rockets. And the explosions, the crashing, all of it, you can get spikes that attach to your tires. It's all just super fun. I was about to get the new car, but you have to go through Mutant Bash TV to get sponsorship. And my game crashes. Every time.
So you didn't get to play it, but I played it, and Mutant Bash TV is the best part of Rage. You just go through these, like, ridiculous neon signs, circus-style, live game show type of things, kind of like us, but totally different, but same in title, where you just kill bandits for fun, and it's so much fun, and you get to use all your weapons. It doesn't replenish your ammo, which I really think it should, because...
In the chat room, Picture Reader has a very good question. Do all games need to have a great story? I mean, unlike other entertainment, games have the chance of just being a fun experience, or is that just meant for portable games? No, you know what? In a case like this, I'm not very far into it, so I don't know how the story is going to develop because it really hasn't even started to develop for me yet the point I'm playing. I don't care. I don't care. There's a lot of side missions that you can go on, again, to earn money and XP and, you know, weapons and stuff like that. I'm enjoying all of that, and I'm enjoying the fact that it's a gorgeous game. The shooting mechanics are super fun. The fact that there is a minimal story is cool, but I don't know, for something like this, I don't mind that. Like, when I started at the game, I disagree with you. I didn't really care that I didn't know what was going on or that there wasn't some kind of overarching thing that I had to be paying attention to.
Well, I mean, for me, it was because the gameplay mechanics worked so well and because I did like the character so much and I really did enjoy to shoot, you know, the enemies so much is that I wanted to know more. Uh-huh. It wasn't that I needed the story to enjoy the game. It was that I enjoyed the game so much, I wanted to know the story. And so it wasn't that I didn't, you know, enjoy the game. It was that I was disappointed that I didn't get to have this connection with the game that I have with other games that do give me that emotional connection. I wish I knew who I was and why I was doing what I was doing. And, I mean, I don't know. Obviously, if there's a Rage 2, I'm sure they'll learn from this. But I mean, I think at the end of the day, this game is a solid first-person shooter.
So good.
So good.
So good.
And it's beautiful. It's so pretty. They managed to take a game where, like, nobody showers and everything's dying and everyone's a mutant. Well, not everyone, but there's a lot of, like, it's radioactive. And there's a city where, like, Dead City. I can't spoil it for you because I don't have any answers, but there are just waterfalls of blood. There's so much blood in that level, and it's still beautiful.
Just one more thing that I want to say that I really like about this before we wrap it up.
Oh, and one more thing, too.
Okay, the AI, I think, is really, really smart. They kind of hide when you're shooting at them. If you hit them, they'll run to another piece of cover. Even in hand-to-hand combat, when a guy is charging at you with just a knife, he's going to zigzag so he doesn't just come at a straight suicidal line at your face. So it's like little touches like that that I really appreciate. And again, just shows that it does first-person shooters really well.
Agreed. And to your point, different bandits, groups, they attack you differently. Mm-hmm. So not only will they react to you differently because the AI is so smart, but they'll react the way that their specific group would react. You know, the Ghost Clan's gonna run right at you, the Shrouded Clan's gonna hide behind you, and maybe send a little RC car at you. But to the AIs, you know, I don't know, it's amazing, I'll say that. But here's something that you need to think about, people.
Uh-oh.
Okay, you need to save yourself.
What?
You need to actually go into the start menu and save when you want to save. Remember that, because when you die, because the checkpoints are really, they're rare, okay? They're after major events, and if you die, you're gonna go back like a 45 minutes.
Maybe it's just me being old, but I guess that's just like so second nature to me that it hasn't really bothered me that much.
I was like 6 hours into Deus Ex before I realized you could even do that.
You are retarded.
Swear to God, swear.
All right, I'm gonna say that, I mean, as far as like the positives outweigh the negatives in this game. It's definitely something you should pick up. It's a gorgeous first-person shooter. There's a lot of content there, regardless of whether or not you're enjoying the story elements. The gameplay itself, there's just hours and hours and hours to it. Not sure how much replayability there is, so maybe in that sense you want to rent it for a week, but you absolutely have to play this game, in my opinion.
Agreed. I agree. While I was disappointed in the story, I would absolutely recommend you play it. Not only is it a great time to be had by all, but for replayability, there's going to be DLC, and I don't know what it's going to offer, but it's going to be amazing, and it's going to extend that story, because God knows it's not going to extend multiplayer. But yeah, pick it up, and if anything, encourage id Software to make more games faster.
Yeah. And that's Rage. Coming up next, the Z List.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1!
Nice. Nice work.
Yeah. All right, so since Rage is all about the end of times, you showed automatically I did that. Here, let me do it again. End of times. I decided to compile the top 5 apocalypse scenarios provided by video games for you. So number 5 is Borderlands. So it's alien tech gone bad, evil corporations are evil. So basically on Pandora, the planet that Borderlands takes place on, all these mega corporations kind of echoing what's going on in America at the time, is actually looking for alien technology, and they are just sucking the planet dry of nutrients, minerals, resources, everything.
Oh, is there a story in Borderlands?
You know there is, and I had to Google it to find it. But hey, I found it.
Fuck you, boss.
I found it.
Wait, there's a story throughout.
Look at him go.
There's like many mini stories
as you pick
up recorders. They're letting you know about
how
there's people stuck on the planet.
I have a paragraph. I wrote about it.
Brian, it's almost easier to set you off about Borderlands than to make you flash back from all the acid you've done.
I was getting big.
I know, I remember that. So point being, the corporations, after they completely ruined the planet, all the rich people bounced, and all the normal people had to stay with the summer. When the summer came, it's kind of like Game of Thrones when winter comes, but it's summer. So aliens and monsters and they're banned, they're psychos. All the psychos come and they kill you. Borderlands.
Total perfect summation.
You're welcome. You also have a car that sucks. Whenever I played with Brian, because yes, Brian loves it, I made him drive. 4, Left 4 Dead. Just the generic zombie taking over the world scenario. It kind of applies to any zombie game. Here's the scenario. There is a disease, an infection. It's contagious. It's highly contagious, like chicken pox contagious. More so, really. And normal people get turned into this brain lusting creatures that just want to kill you, and it affects everyone, so you're just shit out of luck. So that's one scenario for the apocalypse. And it's not a very good one, because there's really no way to win that one. Because have you ever seen a zombie movie or video game where you win? It's really just a checkpoint.
Yeah.
Every game
it's
and
survival.
Book movie ends on a checkpoint.
Yeah, you don't
so
win.
So there's no way to win that one. Suicide. That's where suicide's a good choice. Only a zombie apocalypse! 3. Hey guys, let's bring it back. So since it's the game of the week, we had to put it on there. It's Rage. No, I have the name here. It's an actual asteroid is what kills the entire
Apophis.
Planet. And it's called, what is it?
Apophis.
Apophis. It's named after the Egyptian god of chaos. It's an actual asteroid that will go by Earth in like some time. But scientists like revealed like recently that the chances of this happening are incredibly rare, but whatever, it's gonna happen. And we have Rage as like education. It teaches how to It doesn't teach us anything, actually. But so if an apocalypse happens because of a meteor, all we need to do is get into like a Tupperware, like a a technology infused Tupperware.
Sure, one with a bunch of ice cubes in it.
Yeah, but like ice cubes that will stay cold forever, and yeah. Then we'll be fine. So learn that from Rage.
Lesson learned.
Two is the apocalypse depicted in Fallout 3, which actually is the most scary because it's probably going to happen, and yeah. It's after a nuclear holocaust with China, yeah. Which, let's just be honest, it's gonna happen. We all saw the episode of South Park.
We kind of owe them a little bit of cash.
It's like 30 hundred million billion.
Thereabouts. How does that translate into bottle
it's
caps?
It's in Chinese, so I don't know.
Yeah.
It's a lot of Pip-Boys. But that's actually the most scary, and it actually is going to happen. So start digging in that bunker now, because it's gonna help
get
you.
Get those ice cube
stock
Tupperware
up on Coca-Cola is what the real message is.
Yeah.
Just stock up on soda.
Yeah.
That's gonna help you one day. And maybe Twinkies. I don't think Bethesda addressed that, but they couldn't get copyright. That's the truth. Number one, it's Earth Defense Force Insect Armageddon. Let's face it, guys. If the Armageddon happens, it's gonna happen because giant alien bugs invade. They're gonna look exactly like our bugs, but 100 million kajillion, I'm making up numbers tonight, bigger. Okay? And there's no way we can defeat them because the game sells so well, they're gonna keep making sequels. So that's I don't know what the message is, but Raid, okay? It kills bugs dead.
Yeah, there's your
Johnson
message.
Johnson & Johnson, a family company.
And that's the new one. Guys, special announcement.
What is it?
Oh, what? Stop, game show.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Stop this bullshit.
Special place.
What's going
place.
On? In case you guys don't know, this is Jim. This is Nicole.
Hey there.
And I'm Ethan.
I'm Lindsay.
I'm Andrew.
This is Andrew.
We're from the Real Cool Club.
Oh, we're here now.
We're on the camera down there now.
Yeah,
Ethan.
We're here.
We're down.
Over there.
Nope.
We're on the Real Cool Club. We're out of practice, you guys. We're out of practice.
Yeah. You accommodate us.
You accommodate our bullshit. We kind of have a special announcement.
We do.
A little bit.
Oh, it's even coming toward. How do we not have this on our show? Yeah. How do we not have this?
Welcome to the big time, Ethan.
And lift!
Yay!
All right.
That's like magic.
So the Real Cool Club has been off the air for a couple of weeks. We've been on hiatus. Boo!
But we have
an announcement. We're coming back.
Yay!
And the best part is we're coming back with the game show
on
Friday nights.
Boob camp.
Yeah, that was just Jim's boob camp.
Yeah. We've been planning this for a couple weeks. We wanted to make sure everything was solidified and working out, and it's gonna happen.
Contracts have been signed. I no longer have a soul.
That's right. We took it and gave it to me because I was without one for my entire life.
Enjoy mine.
Yeah, it's very tiny and has Yoshi in it.
It suits him well, actually.
It's a sock.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna be dark next week, so next Friday there won't be shows, nope. But the following Friday, Real Cool Club at 6 Pacific. Game show at 8 p.m. It'll be like that for weeks, because we love you.
We're fucking excited.
We're so stoked.
Friday nights are gonna be fucking amazing at the stream again.
Yay.
It's the whole point of this. Merger. I'm gonna call it a merger.
I'm gonna learn about games.
This is what I call co-op.
No.
Oh, man.
We're gonna take away his camera as soon as he...
Oh, he took away our camera.
Quality is still the same.
I'm going to take away everyone's camera.
All right, so guys, we will not see you next week, but the following week, tune in, 6 p.m. Pacific, 8 p.m. Pacific, Real Cool Club, Game Show, fucking Power Fridays. Guys.
All back. 21st of October.
Tune in.
See you then, guys.